So then the 12-3 part of Ketoflex 12-3, a minimum of 12-hour fast between when you finish dinner and when you start breakfast or brunch or lunch. If you are ApoE4 positive, you're actually a better fat absorber, as you know. So you want to make that 14 to 16 hours. If you're ApoE4 negative, 12 to 14 hours. And be careful, if you have a very low BMI, you can lose weight on this Ketoflex 12-3 diet. And so you have to liberalize typically once a week, have some sweet potatoes or something that's a little more carbohydrate related. And of course, in the book, we talk about the various things that you want to do with this diet. But 12 hours, that gives you time for autophagy. It gives you time essentially at night to induce your ketosis, to clean out your brain. Of course, the lymphatic system, you actually have a change in the architecture of your brain as you're sleeping. You're actually essentially sweeping this stuff out. It's kind of amazing, actually. And so if you're eating with these very small windows of sleep and very small windows of fasting, you're actually doing yourself harm and putting yourself at greater risk. And then similarly, you want 3 hours before bed after you finish your dinner. You don't want to eat right up until bedtime because, you know, your insulin's high. And again, that's hurting your cognition. That's, again, giving you the same sort of insulin resistance problem, storing fat. You're doing all the things that are not helpful. Mm-hmm. So that's the dietary approach. And of course, you want to have organic. There are toxins in our food. It's unfortunate. We've got a tremendous lifelong exposure to toxins. Of course, Bruce Ames, with whom you trained, developed the Ames test, which allows us now to look at carcinogens. But nobody has ever told us, well, hey, what about dementigens? You're exposed every day to various dementigens, things like mercury, things like some of the organics that are in some of the health and beauty aids, and things like biotoxins. If you're living in a home that has leaks, you are exposed to dementigens, and you need to know about that. So that's the Ketoflex 12-3. We want it to be, it's a plant-rich diet. Mark Hyman called plant-rich as opposed to plant-based, but either way, it is a plant-rich diet that can use some animal products. It's up to you. You want to be vegetarian, that's fine. You don't, that's fine too. That minimizes the toxins. You want to have a high, typically 70% or so calories from fat. And you can start out with using things like MCT oil or coconut oil to get your ketones up. We're finding that people who have higher ketone levels, 1.5 millimolar to 4 millimolar beta-hydroxybutyrate, tend to do better than those who are down lower.
ApoE4 positive or negative.
And ApoE4 positive or negative. Now, interestingly, for the ApoE4s, what we typically suggest, and this was actually originally suggested by Julie G, who started the website, apoe4.info, you essentially start with using the MCT oil to help you get your ketosis, but then switch after a month or two to more monounsaturates and polyunsaturates. Now you can essentially balance, so you have the best of both worlds. You follow your LDL particle number, your LDLP. You want to keep it below 1,000. So you can adjust how much MCT oil and how much of the monounsaturates and polyunsaturates so that you have the best heart outcome, the best cardiovascular outcome, at the same time have the best cognitive outcome. Be careful if you don't get your ketones up and you get your carbs down, you're starving your brain. And so then people will say, my gosh, I just have no energy. Right. So you want to use that. You want to basically be changing over to a more ketone-based metabolism for your brain. And then, as you indicated, you want to go, you know, back more toward the, you know, monounsaturates and polyunsaturates to make it heart healthy.
So for this, the ApoE4 positive people, you do recommend lowering the saturated fat intake because of
after
the LDL.
After you become insulin sensitive. Okay. So after you want to drive yourself into insulin sensitivity. So you've got, you know, you're able now to convert. So because it takes a few weeks, as you know, mm-hmm. to convert from a largely carbohydrate-based metabolism mm-hmm. to a largely fat-based metabolism. So if you try to do it in a day, you may end up with so-called keto flu. It takes some time, and you're now producing. It's a whole set of things you're producing. It's going to be less inflammatory. You're lowering your reliance on glucose, you're becoming metabolically flexible, mm-hmm. and you're now essentially developing a use of the ketones. And it just takes a few weeks. It's helpful to do things like exercise and things at that time to help you convert.
And then the fasting, the overnight fasting of at least 12 hours, is, or like you said, if you're APOE4 positive, possibly even increase that to 14 hours.